This is Orekoya. This is Mathematics Fundamentals on the YouTube channel. This morning we are taking on further mathematics, that's calculus. The topic of today is general derivative of a function of the first principle. How do we find the rate of change of dependent variable with respect to independent variable? We are taking on a general function. Like for instance, look at this exercise. Derive the differential coefficient of y is equal to ax raised by n from the first principle. Now, we are given y is equal to ax raised by n. So, to find y prime. Y prime means the y dx from the first principle. That's the question. Now, let there be a small increment in x and a small increment in y. The small increment in x is taken as delta x, and the small increment in y is taken as delta y. We call it infinitesimal increment. That is very small increment in variable x and variable y respectively. That means when there is an increment in y, we write y plus delta y. When there is an increment in x, we say x plus delta x. That's what we have here. Y plus delta y is equal to a brackets, because we are having a outside. It's only the x that is increasing. So you make the a to be a constant. It stays where it is. So we add to x. That is x plus delta x, then everything is equal to n. Now, but this expression, x plus delta x raised by n, from the binomial theorem, we know that x plus delta x raised by n is the summation of combination r, x raised by n minus r, delta x raised by r. What am I trying to say is that we have this independent variable x. Now, with respect to increments in x, in order to expand this raised to power n, this power can be of any integer form. Now, we say it's the summation. We are taking this counter from r is equal to 0 to the n, the power we are referring to. So the formula is this. Summation means we are going to be adding this one. When r is 0, when r is 1, when r is 2, and so on and so forth, until when r is n. Now, expanding this, we substitute when r is 0. We substitute 0 anywhere with still r there. Then when r is 1, we substitute 1 to anywhere r is, according to our counter. When r is 2, we substitute 2 to where r is. Then when r, until we add up to n. So when r is n, we put n anywhere you see r. Now, each of the coefficients, n combination 0, is n factorial over n minus 0 factorial, 0 factorial. And n minus 0 factorial is equal to n factorial, that. N factorial cancel n factorial, 0 factorial. And 0 factorial in mathematics is 1. So we are left with n factorial over n factorial. N factorial divided by n factorial is 1. Now, n combination 1 means n factorial over n minus 1 factorial, 1 factorial. So now, in order to cancel n minus 1 factorial, we can extend n factorial as n times n minus 1 factorial over n minus 1 factorial, 1 factorial. N minus 1 factorial cancel n minus 1 factorial. So we are left with n over 1 factorial, and 1 factorial is 1. So that means n combination 1 is n. The same thing is applicable to n combination 2. We have this. Now, substituting each of these coefficient back to what we have here in this expression, then we are having this arrangement. When y substitution, therefore x plus delta x raised by n is the same as x raised by n plus n times f n raised by minus 1 delta x plus n bracket n minus 1 divided by 2 x raised by n minus 2 delta x squared plus until we have delta x raised by n. Now, coming back to the expression we have here, when we want to make delta y subject of formula, the y is taken to the other side of the equation. That means we are having delta y is equal to a bracket s plus delta s raised by n minus y. And our y originally is a s raised by n. So now, coming down to this place, this is what I just said now. This expression we have here is what we have already derived here. So to see that part of this place, then this a n minus y, and our y is a x raised by n. Putting them back, open the bracket, a will multiply everything inside this bracket. We have this expression as it is. That means that our y is a x raised by n plus a n x raised by n minus 1 delta s plus a n bracket n minus 1 x raised by n minus 1 divided by 2 delta s squared plus until plus a s a delta s raised by n minus a x raised by n. Now we are looking for delta y divided by delta x. So dividing through by delta x. That means we are putting delta s under each of these terms. We have all these arrangements. Delta s will be cancelling anywhere we have delta s up there. And using the law of indices and in the writing the expression. So this delta s cancels this delta s. We have this. Now this delta s will cancel one of the delta s there. One delta s is left below. N plus a delta s raised by n delta x. This delta s is raised by 1. From law of indices, become delta s raised by n minus 1. Now, we are now to find the limits of delta y with respect to delta s as delta s tends to 0. That means each of the delta s we are having here will tend towards 0. When delta s tends towards 0 here, the whole of this expression is tending towards 0. And when delta s tends to 0 here, the whole of this expression is tending towards 0. But since we do not have delta s here, the whole of this expression remains the way it is. So the limits of delta y to delta s and delta s tends to 0 in mathematics, we call it the y to x. So the limit we are having now is a n x raised by n minus 1. Therefore, for every y is equal to a s raised by n, the y the s is a s raised by n minus 1. What we are trying to say in essence that when we are having y, to find y prime, which is the y the x, use the power to multiply and subtract 1. So this is the proof. So you can subscribe, share, and recommend me, Orekoya, when we share your physics fundamental, further mathematics on YouTube. Thank you.